Well, school board officials call this move by the state a political power grab to get the district's more than $220 million budget. But those same state lawmakers, including two who represent this very community, say it was time for drastic measures.
Come prepared with the expertise as well as the financial commitment to help us elevate our academic programs.
Hempstead school board members seemed resigned, though clearly frustrated about the state's near takeover of the district. Late last night, the assembly approved a bill that gives unprecedented power to a three-person panel to veto the superintendent selection and all spending. It came after an impassioned plea from Hempstead Assemblywoman Taylor Rayner.
I am so sorry for the thousands of children that did not receive the education and development opportunities they were entitled to.
Hempstead schools have struggled for years. Recently, the graduation rate dropped as low as 37%, one of the lowest in the country, and the district has been plagued by infrastructure and overcrowding issues.
These dismal graduation numbers line the pathway to poverty, and where there's poverty, there's usually crime. So in the Hempstead School District, we currently have an educational environment that fuels the school-to-prison pipeline.
But board members argue the state has already been in this community in an advisory role, and that's working well. They point to a slow but steady building improvement plan and a graduation rate now around 60%, although there have been accusations of grade manipulation.
You don't get accepted into Harvard, Princeton, Yale, these type of schools if the grades are being changed. These students earned it, and it's smack in their face for these allegations to be made.
The board members are urging Governor Cuomo to veto. The governor hasn't made a comment about that just yet. Live in Hempstead, Henry Rossoff, PIX 11 News.